And finally, ASAP Natin To in Ontario, California is only 2 days away. And several staples of ASAP met with members of the media.
Thank you all very much for supporting TFC's 30th anniversary.
When you're able to perform with a family like this, it takes it to a different level. And then we are excited to bring a piece of home to the hearts of everyone that's going to be watching.
We really get to see the people who have kept TFC and all of us alive, our careers alive. This is our chance to give back and thank everyone on a personal basis.
Fans got up close and personal with their idols, dancing with BGYO and Beanie, playing games with Darren, Kyle, Inigo, and the love team of Dawn Bell. As the stars and fans count down to Saturday's show, tickets may be tougher to come by.
As of last night, ASAP 2024 is officially sold out.
Yes!
And those are the newsmaking headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.
A New York State appeals court rejects Donald Trump's challenge to a gag order in his hush money case. The decision means the Republican presidential nominee cannot comment publicly about individual prosecutors and others in the case until Justice Juan Merchan sentences him on September 18, seven weeks before the November 5 election. Trump's lawyers have argued the gag order violates his right to free speech. Last May, jurors found Trump guilty on 34 felony counts of falsifying business records to cover up hush money payments to adult film star Stormy Daniels before the 2016 election. Now, family members of hostages and demonstrators gather in Tel Aviv to mark 300 days since the October 7th attack on southern Israel that triggered the Gaza War. Protesters set a 300 sign on fire and launched lanterns in the sky. Qatar, Egypt, and the U.S. have repeatedly tried to clinch a ceasefire deal between Israel and Hamas. But there was no sign of progress at the latest round of talks in Rome on Sunday for a final deal to halt nearly 10 months of war and the release of the remaining Israeli hostages. U.S. President Joe Biden announces the release of Americans held in Russia in the biggest East-West prisoner exchange since the end of the Cold War. The complex deal involving six countries and 24 individuals was negotiated in secrecy for more than a year. They include Evan Gershkovich, a Wall Street Journal reporter accused of collecting sensitive military information for the CIA, and U.S. Marine Paul Whelan, who was also accused of espionage. Relatives of some of the freed prisoners appeared at the White House as Biden announced the deal.
We're bringing home Paul, Evan, also Vladimir. Three American citizens and one American green card holder. All four have been imprisoned unjustly in Russia. Paul for nearly 6 years, Vladimir since 2022, Evan since March of 2023, and Alsu since October of 2023. Russian authorities arrested them, convicted them in show trials, and sentenced them to long prison terms with absolutely no legitimate reason whatsoever. This is an incredible relief for all the family members gathered here. It's a relief to the friends and colleagues all across the country who've been praying for this day for a long time.
Also released were activists and dissidents who had worked with leading Russian opposition figure Alexei Navalny. The White House confirms the exchange had been intended to include Navalny before his death.
Today's exchange is a feat of diplomacy that honestly could only be achieved by a leader like Joe Biden. At his direction, the professionals in our national security, foreign policy, and intelligence community worked tirelessly and relentlessly to secure the release of 16 individuals who were detained in Russia.
The White House also says no money was exchanged and no sanctions loosened to facilitate the deal. Russian nationals involved in a complex swap of prisoners with Western countries arrived in Moscow late on Thursday. They were met at the airport by President Vladimir Putin, who thanked them for their loyalty. The Kremlin says Moscow's decision to pardon and free prisoners had been made in order to bring Russian captives home. The last major exchange between the U.S. and Russia in 2010 involved 14 prisoners. The two countries had a high-profile exchange in December 2022, swapping U.S. basketball star Brittney Griner for arms dealer Victor Bout, who was serving a 25-year sentence.